left direction, or the wave traveling toward left. And when k is positive, when k is plus, from that expression, when k is plus, then means greater than zero, the wave is traveling in right direction. The wave is traveling in right direction. So we have included now a constant is no not that a, it is any constant. It may be the multiplication of a and b, so it is a constant. And then this wave function, and here inside k we have included that it can take both positive and negative values. So this way our wave function is represented by psi k. Now this wave function we will have to means a wave, this wave is actually traveling to the right, and this wave is traveling to the left as well. So both direction it can extend to infinity. Now when a wave is extending to infinity, then how we will be able, because we know that when x goes to infinity, our wave function psi of x should go to zero. Now here our wave is going to infinity in this direction as well as this direction. So whether our wave is going to infinity, so it is not. It means we will have to normalize this wave. Otherwise, it is not a physically realizable state unless and until we normalize this wave, because it is extending to infinity, and we will have to normalize this thing because our solution is supposed to be a stationary state solution in the form this or this. So we will have to normalize this wave function first in order to proceed with the solution of the Schrodinger wave equation, the right solution. So in order to see this thing, we will have to normalize psi k, and the index k that we have written here is due to the reason that we have given the free particle the two states of k plus and minus, and it's a free particle and it can go this way as well as it can go the other way. So we will have the normalization condition from minus infinity to plus infinity. We are having psi mod square dx equal to 1, which will become from minus infinity to plus infinity, and psi conjugate into sine dx equals 1. So from here I can write that from minus infinity to plus infinity, the psi k conjugate with psi k and dx is equal to 1, and this implies that psi k, when I take the conjugate of it, this I will become minus, and with psi k this will be plus, so it will be a square and e to the power plus I and minus I, and it will become e to the power 0. So from minus infinity to plus infinity, this is a mod square, and this is e to the power 0 dx, and this is equal to a mod square, and the result will be x only, because e0 is 1, so x, and from minus infinity to plus infinity x dx. So this will be a mod square, and this will become x from minus infinity to plus infinity, and this is equal to a mod square, and this will become infinity. And this is really very strange that our wave function came out to be not normalizable. What does it mean that when our wave function is not normalizable? This means that the stationary state solution, this means that the stationary states solution are actually not, the stationary state solution is not realizable, is not physically realizable solution. So they are, I say that this implies that the stationary states are not physically, are not physically realizable. The stationary states are not physically realizable. So when the stationary states are not physically realizable, then it means that the free particle, I can write that the free particle is not having definite energy. Means it is not having a definite energy because the states are not physically realizable. As we were having definite energies here in the case of infinite square well, we were having definite energies of the wave function. We were having physically realizable states, and now this particle, this free particle, is not having any definite energy because its wave function is not normalizable. Here we are having this thing undefined. So this is the reason that the free particle can have any energy. It cannot have a specific or definite energy. Now, how to resolve this problem? Because what we actually want, we want that our general solution, we want that our general solution should be a linear combination, should be a linear combination of stationary states. The general solution should be a linear combination of stationary states, and as we know that k is continuous. Now, is k is continuous, so it means that we will have the summation of all the k values, and due to this, Due to this, I will write that psi x t is equal to 1 over 2 pi square root 1 over 2 pi integral from minus infinity to plus infinity and phi of k e to the power I k x minus I k x minus h bar square k, sorry, h bar k square over 2 m t and d k. So I will integrate all this on dk. Now here we will have to note few things, that psi of k is actually my general solution of the wave function, while the 1 over 2 pi that I am using is for normalization convenience, for normalization convenience. And the as a whole, this thing which I have written, which is 1 over 2 pi and phi of k and dk, this is actually playing the role of the constant whose mod square is the probability, and this is actually that cn that we have already discussed. So we have the general solution in this form. Now let me discuss a little bit about this one, that for appropriate value of phi of k, our wave function, our psi x t will be normalizable. So if we find this phi of k and our wave function will be normalizable, and as we know that k is continuous, it's a range of values. As k is continuous, then we don't have a specific value for ek. So ek means the energy associated with this k is not single valued, but have a range of values. Means ek is not a single valued, but is having a range of values, and this thing we call, now what kind of values? The values of energy and speed of a wave. Means different speeds, different energies are actually there. So we are not having a single value, so it means it is not a single wave, but it is actually waves, and those waves are having different energies and different speeds, and we call them as a wave packet. In this wave packet, we are having different waves. Each of the wave is going with its own specific speed, and specific energy, but as a whole, this is going as a wave packet, not as a single wave. And we, let me discuss a little bit about the X space and the K space. We know that X space we call is real space, while K space we call is reciprocal space, or we call this is momentum space. This we also called reciprocal space. Why? Because we know that K is one over length dimension, one over X. So X space, K is reciprocal space. Now why we actually do this thing? Our wave function, which was psi of X, and with time it was psi XT, it was not normalizable. It was not normalizable in space. So what we did, we consider momentum space. Now if the space is this much, then reciprocal space will be shortened. So that's why we considered phi as a function of K. This is a wave function which is part of our wave, means this one, which actually gives the amplitude of it. Because here the amplitude of it, or the normalization of it, was giving infinity, undefined. So we consider its amplitude to become normalized or become physically realizable. So phi of K. So we considered the K space instead of the real space. And if we find the value of phi K, then our psi x of t will be physically realizable, will become physically realizable. So our wave function will become physically realizable. And now how to do this thing? We will utilize the Fourier trick or the Fraenkel theorem in order to find the value of phi k. So this is the reason that when our k was continuous and it is having a range of values associated with different energies, then energies are different, their speeds will be different as well, and the waves will actually behave like a wave packet. So we moved from the real space, because in the real space our wave function was not normalizable, we moved to the K space, which is called the momentum space. So we have come to our wave function, which is psi x of t. We wrote the general solution in terms of phi of k and ei kx h bar k square over 2m. So we will have to determine the value of this phi k in a momentum space. It can be determined, and then our psi x of t will become normalizable. Now, is in real space, our general solution will be this one. But for determining the phi of k, I consider that at t equals 0, then our wave function is psi x of 0. And because with time our wave function is not changing, its shape remains the same. So for determining the phi of k value, I will utilize psi of x0 and I can write that psi of x0